I'm here with Lionel and Miko. And Lionel, you've never used Tinkercad before, correct? Okay. And Miko, you're going to explain to them how to use it?
Yes.
And it's a browser-based 3D design program?
Yeah, it's a solid CAD with written in the browser.
Okay.
It has two simple tools. One is Add Tool, which you can pick over here. And then you can choose some simple shapes. And then you click somewhere over here to add stuff. So you can click and drag to actually create like a longer shapes. Just like that. And then the second tool is Subtract, which basically removes stuff. The same thing, it works exactly the same way as the Add tool, and it allows you to remove things. Let's say make holes or channels and that kind of stuff.
And what do you need for software to run this? What browser does it like?
Chrome and Firefox are the best ones.
Okay.
We try to support like all of them. Microsoft says that IE won't support WebGL, so that's out of the question, but it works with Chrome Frame.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. And where can people go to find out more about it?
People can find more about Tinkercad at tinkercad.com.
Okay.
And it's a free service. We want to basically enable a lot of people to be able to do designs for 3D printing, and that sort of like small things that can be printed out at home.
Okay. And what can you output the file as?
You can output the file to, can you click here on 3D, print 3D? Basically, integrate directly with iMaterials and Shopify currently. We are adding more services, so you can use the shops to actually do the printing. Or you can download STL file, which is sort of standard file format for 3D printing.
That's great. Yeah. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right.